we can begin business. And the nominations that were previously on the agenda are not on the agenda. They're not going to be considered today. So all we have is three bills, and if we could read the first one.
Thank you, Senator. First bill on our agenda today is Senate Bill 597 by Senator Fischullo. This is an act to amend the executive law in relation to prohibiting sex offenders from being entitled to licenses as state-certified and licensed real estate appraisers. Specifically, this bill would amend the executive law to authorize the Department of State to deny the issuance of a certificate to a state-certified real estate appraiser or a license as a state-licensed real estate appraiser or a real estate appraiser assistant if such person was convicted of a sex offense or a violent sex offense and required to register under New York Sex Offender Registration Act.
Are there any questions? Discussion? All in favor? It looks like it's unanimous. No one's opposed. The bill is reported to the full House. 1071, Senator Libous.
This is an act to amend the state finance law in relation to establishing the Bridge and Road Investment and Dedicated Fund Guaranteed Enforcement Bridge Reform Act. Specifically, this bill would amend the state finance law to direct funding for necessary road and bridge repair in New York by removing expenses not related to repair and construction. This would include costs that are presently in such fund for the Department of Motor Vehicles, and it would phase off the cost of snow and ice removal from the state's dedicated highway and bridge trust fund. This bill passed in 2008 by 61-0.
Move the bill.
Senator DeLon.
Yeah, I know that this bill is removing the DMV and snow and ice removal from state operations, and it phases out what money goes into DMV for its operation over 5 years. But we at the same time are phasing out the fees that DMV provides to the fund over the same period of time.
No.
How does that make sense then? Because right now, the money that DMV is putting in to the fund more than covers what it gets back. So how would DMV then operate?
It's based on a separate line. It wouldn't flow through this dedicated fund.
It still would come from the dedicated fund?
It would not flow through the dedicated fund.
So it would flow through the general fund. So why can't DMV just operate with its own fees and the balance go into the general fund?
That I cannot speak to.
Well, I guess that's an option, but that's not what the bill would call for. It would call for those fees that apparently to go through the general fund.
The current fund would just, this bill only addresses expenses going out. So it's just talking about where would DMV funds be funded from and taking it out of the dedicated fund and just to the general fund.
Well, you know,
we may want to address later what
you're... The problem I have with the bill is that it takes out money that goes into DMV and the appearance is given that the operators out of the fund is paying the expenses for DMV, but it's really the other way around, that all of DMV's revenue is going into the fund and then money's flowing back to pay DMV's expenses. So to view the way that it's structured, I definitely have a problem with this bill. I have other questions that I'm going along.
Senator, as a point of clarification, because the fees are not repealed, it just takes them out of this dedicated fund and puts them through the general fund as the default.
I don't think that the bill is clear in that respect.
Okay. Any other comments? Discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
Without rec.
Without rec, Senators Krueger and Senator DeLon. Senator Rivera. The bill is reported out. 4006A, Skelos.
This is an act to amend the legislative law in relation to establishing the New York State Legislative Budget Office, to amend the state finance law and the legislative law in relation to enacting a balanced budget requirement, and to amend the state finance law in relation to budget reform and enacting performance budgets. Specifically, this bill would create the New York State Independent Budget Office to provide for objective, nonpartisan analysis of state revenues, expenditures, and management practices. Requires that the submitted executive and enacted budgets be balanced in accordance with generally accepted accounting principles. It would establish a five-year financial plan, create a means of evaluating the performance of programs in New York, allowing both the governor and the legislature to make modifications as necessary under programming performances, and enact a requirement for performance budgeting.
Questions? Senator Krueger.
Thank you. I think it's not so much questions, particularly since the sponsor is not here, but I just wanted to go on the record. This bill is a variation on a bill that I have carried for several years, and it makes some significant changes from the bill that I'm carrying, and I'm hopeful that Senator Skelos may consider amending his bill before it comes to the floor. Just a few of the changes. In the creation of a legislative budget office, which many members of both houses have carried on both sides of the aisle for several years, in this bill, they remove the responsibility of the legislative budget office to review tax expenditures, but increases the mandate of the LBO to look at mandates on local governments and impacts on the private sector. I don't disagree with having the LBO look at unfunded mandate questions, but I think it's a serious mistake to remove review of tax expenditures from the purpose of that organization. My biggest concern is in this bill, the LBO would be funded by taking 20% of the funds currently appropriated to the Division of Budget. One, I think there's probably constitutional challenges to taking money away from the governor, executive chamber, DOB, to take approximately 20%, which I think currently would be $10.1 million. But actually, we don't take on in the LBO the responsibilities of DOB or take away responsibilities for them. So I could see this actually being challengeable, and ironically, it's funded through DOB budget as opposed to the concept of a combination of current assembly and Senate finance staff. Total today between the assembly and the Senate is $11.6 million, and if it was traded in some way with a take from the DOB, we'd actually end up with less money to run these functions than we currently have, and probably face the, again, constitutional legal challenge of saying we're going to take the money away from DOB's budget. On gap balance budgeting, which is another important section of the bill and one that I've worked hard on in the last several years, in this version of the bill, it doesn't create a board to certify that the legislature's budget is balanced, and leaves it to the legislature to simply declare. We believe we've met gap budgeting requirements, and I think that there's a serious mistake in taking away the professional role of a body to evaluate that, and also to recognize that there are times when a government needs to make exceptions. There are emergency situations that could come up. 9/11 is obviously the most recent one in our past where the legislature needed to make a decision in the middle of a budget year to spend additional money or to change how it was spending money that probably could not have been done in a strict gap model without some mechanism for dealing with emergencies. So I'm going to also be talking to Senator Skelos about the technical complications of not doing gap balance budgeting with the right emergency valves, and bless you, Senator, and without the process. Further, I actually think that Senator Skelos's proposal to do five-year detailed reporting is a very good addition to the bill. So I wanted to just go on record as saying I thought that that was a significant improvement in the clarification and details of the responsibilities of this entity. And finally, Senator Skelos's bill has a mandate for performance-based budgeting, which there have also been a number of bills floating around both houses for several years. I am a strong proponent of performance-based measurement, but it also can be very complicated and one size does not fit all, which is why actually in my version of the bill, we create a commission to evaluate how best to do this. And in Senator Skelos's, it's almost an assumption that it just gets done, and I don't think realistically we would see that happening. So I'm certainly not recommending a no vote today, but I wanted to go on record with the Finance Committee of why I think there are pros and cons and that we should work together, both sides of the aisle, to make the bill that hopefully we can get past both houses and signed by the governor the strongest bill possible. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Krueger. Any other comments or discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed?
I'd like to especially in light of the concerns that I shared that the right put forward. So I hope that those concerns are taken into serious consideration and that there's an opportunity to have some kind of meeting and discussion to bring into this bill some of those concerns and make it better.
Thank you, Senator Perkins without rec. The bill is reported out. And that completes the calendar. The meeting is adjourned.